What's the best way to increase ferritin? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
And Deanna has several questions. So I'll get to number one first. So number one, ferritin level. How to increase ferritin level. I'm historically having a low level of ferritin based on my last 2 years of lab tests. The recent test shows ferritin being 23 nanograms per milliliter, optimal range 60 to 232. But my iron level is above optimal zone being 136, optimal 60 to 107. I've been taking iron supplements in the form of iron chelate, but it did not help my ferritin level. How to optimize ferritin? I've read that several types of foods can reduce the amount of non-heme iron that the body absorbs. For example, the tannins in coffee and tea, dairy products, fiber, eggs, and some types of chocolate can inhibit the absorption of non-heme iron. I drink a lot of black tea daily. Could this potentially be a reason for my low ferritin? Yeah, it could be. So I guess my first suggestion would be, if you're taking an iron chelate supplement, then you should probably take it with a carnivore meal. I was saying this earlier with the vegan who had low zinc. Zinc and iron are both very much animal, carnivore nutrients. Vitamin C and a few other, folate are, not really vegan nutrients, but they're very plant-oriented nutrients in terms of what's the thing you're probably going to add to your diet that's going to help. And so, if I really feel like if I had iron deficiency anemia, I would probably just spend 4 weeks on a carnivore diet that was rich in red meat and pork meats. If I really wanted to just pick a simple dietary plan, go all in on it. Now, a compromise to that would be the iron supplement's not working, apart from increasing the dose of the supplement, which is one thing you can do. But the first thing I would do is take that supplement, eat one meal a day that is just straight up carnivore, that has no plants, no tea, no chocolate, and take the iron supplement with that meal. Because I feel like it would be very difficult for most people. I mean, obviously there's a lot of carnivores out there, but it'd be very difficult for the average person who's not drawn to doing a carnivore diet, such as myself, to just hole in, go on carnivore. But I think it's not that hard to be like, okay, I'm gonna eat one meal a day where I'm just gonna have red meat. I'm just gonna eat a steak and I'm gonna take my iron supplement. And if it doesn't fill me up, I'm gonna eat more steak. And then eat whatever you want at the other meals. Because even though there's a lot of iron in plant foods, it's just plant foods are full of iron absorption inhibitors. And I will say personally, I am prone to iron overload, but when I'm eating a diet that has a lot of red meat and has a lot of vegetables, 70 or 80% of the iron is coming from my plant foods, and I'll get 45 milligrams of iron in a day and my iron levels don't go up. And I think it's because plant foods, even though they have a lot of iron, a lot of them do, they're just so full of iron absorption inhibitors that they are more negative on iron than they are positive. And I think that that's where I would start first. And from what I've read, it's not eggs. It's egg whites, but I think egg yolks are okay. But, you know, even still, you're going to have better iron status if you're eating more red meat rather than egg yolks. So I'm not saying don't eat egg yolks, but I'm just saying, you know, eat that steak-based carnivore meal with the iron supplement and see if that helps better. Other than that, I mean, you can increase the dose or you can get iron infusions, but I think as a first step, that is a nice balance for practicality and effectiveness.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Masterpass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.